Matthew
chapter is 5. And the verses are
43 to 45.
You have heard that it was said, "You shall love your neighbor and hate your enemy." But I say to you, love your enemies, bless those who curse you, do not do good to those who hate you, and pray for those who spitefully use you and persecute you. That you shall be sons of your Father in heaven, for he makes the sun rise on the evil and the good, and sends rain on the just and on the unjust. Now, to give you a brief summary on the scripture that we just read, this is this is part of the Sermon on the Mount. Now, chapter 5, the Sermon on the Mount is divided into two sections, which are spread from chapter 5 to chapter 7. Now, chapter 5, the first part, outlines the nature of the true religion of Christianity. This is where Jesus talks about blessed are those salt of the earth and the light and the fulfilling of the law.
Chapter
6, Jesus talks about having the right intentions and separating actions from worldly desires.
Chapter 7,
my favorite, provides cautions we should be aware of that hinder us from being proper Christians. Now, we'll be reading from chapter 5 today. Now, throughout the chapter, there's something scholars call an antithesis. Now, an antithesis is displayed throughout the scripture, throughout chapter 5, where Jesus said, "You have heard, but I say unto you."
So, let's say,
for example, Jesus says that you have heard that you shall love thy neighbor and hate your
enemies.
However, Jesus says, contrary to popular belief, I tell you to love your enemies. Bless those who curse you. Do good to those who hate you. Pray for those who spitefully use you and persecute you.
That
you may be sons of your Father in heaven. Now, the late Nelson Mandela once said, as I walked up the door towards the gate, that would lead to my freedom. I knew that if I didn't leave my bitterness and hatred behind, I'd still be in prison. For me, I have a problem with forgiveness. I find it hard to forgive. But the Bible teaches us that when you do not forgive or when you hate.
Bible le Mandela ba re.
You come in prison.
wa bo bogisega.
You see, the Bible teaching is that when we love,
how rata,
it is not for the next person.
How rata le motho o mongwe.
It is for yourself.
Ke gore wa ithatela tota.
So allow me to suggest to you guys that maybe love is not is a selfish act.
Me ke lo re ke re lo rato ke selo se neng gore ke sa boikgogomoso. Ha se selo se neng gore se ke sa motho o mongwe. Ke sa gago.
Now the word enemy.
Lo go kole maba.
Comes from the Latin word enetimus.
Le tswa go le go kon la se Latina le le reng enetimus.
Yes man.
We generally just use love. Now, in modern terms, not everyone who's not your friend is your enemy.
Most of them be known as one of them who is in Zalayahao.
An enemy is defined as someone whose goals, intentions, and aspirations oppose
themselves. Mabaki Montaino, for a kilo to Taha, a kilo Taha, Kitsiri Len Katanon Litaha.
Now, the Lord says that. He makes the sun rise on the evil and on the good and sends rain for the just and the unjust.
Udira hore letsatsi le tlhabele ba ba siameng le ba ba sa siamang le pula inele batho botlhe.
Now remember earlier on I said that chapter 5 talks about the nature of being a true Christian. And we always say that Christianity is not only principle but also practice. The scripture that we just read from also says that so that we may be sons of the Father in heaven. So allow me to submit to you tonight that when we love one another, those who hate us and persecute us
and
our enemies. We
glorify
the Lord.
Amen. Amen.